Advent of Code. What do we got? Okay, 300 by 300. Have the thing. We want the one with the largest total power. Okay, looks simple enough. Top left coordinates. though? RC stuff was a terrible mistake. somehow. Failing maybe. Okay, so what's going on here? So we have the 300 by 300 grid. We have some weird formula for calculating the value of each cell, which is wrapped up in this power function. Fine, it works. So we compute that grid. And now we're going to compute the partial sums. So the point is that GG CR was a bad mistake instead of XY. Just got confusing. But anyway, C is just X and R is just Y. So the point is, GG of CR, I don't know why it, yeah, anyway, is just the sum for columns less than that column, less than or equal to that column, and rows less than or equal to that row of GCR, right? So it's just the sum of the rectangle up to CR. So there's this nice little trick for computing this, which is so imagine that we want the partial sum up to I. ABC that equals that's A plus B plus D plus E plus G plus H plus A plus B plus C plus D plus E plus F minus A plus B plus D plus E plus I. And if you just like look at those terms, it all adds up. And the point is that the sum of this whole square is the sum of this rectangle plus the sum of this rectangle, and we've double counted inside here. And now the only thing that's left is I. So anyway, that's the identity that we're using here. And there's some code to verify that is actually correct. So now we have the partial sums. And now we can just go through all possible rectangles, which we're identifying by their size and their bottom right coordinate, which is confusing. So if it's actually a valid rectangle, like none of it's off the grid, then the score, and this is a similar trick to before, just imagine that these A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I represent blocks instead of individual squares, right? But it's still true that, like, say, the E, F, H, I block is just the sum up to I minus the sum from G minus the sum from C plus the sum from A. So any square, or indeed any rectangle, we can compute this sort of sum of the coordinates in that rectangle in constant time using this identity. That's the point of these partial sums. This is a nice trick. So anyway, compute that in constant time, and then we just take the max. And the point is, there's only like 300 cubed of these rectangles, like 27 million. It's a little less, because for bigger sizes, there's less possible coordinates. But anyway, it's not too big. So we can just find out that result. And that is it. I'm not quite sure how like x and y got flipped here. Clearly they did. Oh, I think it's because I flipped them here. Yeah, I was inconsistent about whether or not I was accessing GRC or GCR. Okay, well, that's done with me. And anyway, we had the bottom right coordinate in a zero-indexed grid, so we need to do something silly to get the top left coordinate in a one-indexed grid. That's what's going on here. So that's it.